Uh-oh, so you tested positive. Measles, measles, measles. Ah, it's not a myth. Measles can be prevented. Hey everybody, I'm Dr. Wagner. Today we're going to talk about measles. You see it all over the news right now. Measles outbreak, more measles cases, measles, measles, measles. Ah, so what do you do? How do you avoid getting the measles? More importantly, what is measles? And are you gonna die if you get measles? All valid questions. I'm gonna go over all of that, plus clear up some myths about measles and what you should do if you think you have measles or if you've been exposed to measles. What is measles? Measles is a highly contagious respiratory virus that affects your lungs and your breathing. Humans are the only natural hosts of the measles virus. Symptoms? What are the symptoms of measles? What does it look like? Symptoms include fevers that are really high, 105, weakness, fatigue, cough, and coryza, which is actually a fancy word for acute inflammation of your nasal cavity or just nasal congestion, and also conjunctivitis, AKA pink eye. Then, more specifically to measles, are colic spots. These spots look like tiny grains of white sand surrounded by red circle on the inside of your cheeks. The other is rash. Rash, rash, rash. Very distinctive characteristic of measles. The rash starts on the head and the face and works its way down to the body, trunk, stomach, and then into your arms and to your legs. Who's at risk, you ask? Infants, children less than the age of 5, adults older than the age of 20, pregnant women, and people with a compromised immune system. How is measles transmitted? In other words, how can you get it or how can I get it? Well, brace yourself. Measles is one of the most contagious of all infectious diseases. Up to 9 out of 10 susceptible persons with close contact to a measles patient will develop measles. I repeat, will develop measles. The virus is transmitted by direct contact with infectious droplets or by airborne spread when an infected person breathes, coughs, or sneezes. So if you're making out with somebody who has measles, or you just happen to be in the same room as somebody, it makes no difference. The measles virus can remain infectious in the air for up to 2 hours. This is why measles is such a big deal if and when you come to the hospital. I know it's our first thought when you are sick to come to an ER, an urgent care, or other medical office. But let's say you come to the emergency department and you actually have measles. You could potentially increase the risk of infecting everybody in the waiting room, their families and friends that they come into contact with. So what do you do if you think you have measles? Number one, contact your primary care doctor or call your local health department. Health department? It's easily Googleable by a quick search. And if you're still very concerned, you can go to the emergency department, but don't go inside right away. Notify them that you are potentially concerned that you might have the measles and have a trained healthcare provider see you outside of the emergency department. The reason being is to get pre-screened before you come in, and if there is a high suspicion for measles by the doctor or the nurse in charge, they will take the necessary precautions and take you to a special area in the emergency department designed with reverse airflow to stop or at least reduce the spread of the infectious disease. All right, how do we know as a doctor or a medical professor if you actually have measles and not something just sneaks up and looks similar to it? Lab tests. Laboratory confirmation is essential for all sporadic measles cases and all outbreaks. Detection of measles-specific basically, we have different lab tests to detect for measles. It's not a myth. Measles can be prevented with a measles-containing vaccine, which is primarily administered as the combination measles, mumps, rubella vaccine, or the MMR. One dose of the MMR vaccine is approximately 93% effective in preventing measles. Two doses are approximately 97% effective. Uh-oh, so you tested positive. Now what? Well, there's no specific treatment for measles, rather mostly supportive care, which means rest, hydration, and controlling your fevers and cough. If you aren't severely sick and you don't really require hospital time and admission, doctor's advice is to stay home, isolate yourself for at least 4 days after you develop the rash. If, on the other hand, you are sick and require a hospital stay for supportive care, you can be given a high dose vitamin A infusion, which may help. Can you die? Well, stats say 1 to 3 out of every 1,000 children can die from measles complications. and one out of every 1,000 cases of measles can develop permanent brain damage. So this is why you're hearing about all the hype over measles on the news and in the headlines. It's a big deal to take the necessary precautions to keep those you love safe, happy, and healthy. That's been your 5 minutes on measles with me, Dr. Wagner. I hope I've cleared up some of the myths about measles and helped you get a better understanding of this highly, highly infectious communicable disease. Make sure you leave me a comment on what other diseases or medical topics that you'd like me to make a video about. And make sure that you subscribe to this channel, turn on your bell notifications, that way you can learn about the new videos that I'll post. Thank you so much for watching, and stay healthy, my friends.